Hello, my friends, and welcome to Amnesia Justine with me, Notorious BLT. This is Justine. Now, there were some things that it said beforehand, like, it was good of you to come, this is going to be a test of character, what are you waiting for, wake up and go, something like that. So I'm not really sure what to expect other than more pants-shitting terror. Oh, also it said, death is final. Hopefully this isn't, like, Amnesia the roguelike. That would be unfortunate, because I am bad at video games. Okay, hi. Well then.
Disembodied voice. It will serve you no purpose to look for me, for this is a voice from the past. I bid you welcome to my cabinet of perturbation. It is my study of the human psyche, specifically yours. A set of recordings have been prepared to chaperone you through the chambers ahead. There are a few parts to this study, and it is up to you, not only to pass, but to figure out what elements are important. Please go on. Move into the next chamber.
Oh, God.
But remember, they can all be safe. There is always a way.
What? This is some fucking portal shit is what this is. We are recording audio, yeah? Okay, good. Wait, why is my vision all poopy? Oh, I don't have any... So one thing I still don't get out about the previous amnesia is why Daniel would take the amnesia stuff. Saw one of the goobies in there. What the fuck? What the fuck? Yeah, lantern's still not working, huh? Oh, fuck. Should I go back? I don't know. Probably? I should probably explore everything, huh? I don't know. Alright, that's where I think I saw a gooby. Why am I... Vision got all poopy. Did I go over here already? Is this where I came... This is where I came from. So it should be noted, I don't have any tinder boxes. I don't have any lantern fuel. Oh. Fah. So there wasn't shit I could do over there. Alright, let's get the fuck out of here then. I mean, really? Is that all I can do? It's just, okay, get the ladder and go, I guess. Let's get the hell out of here. Now, I'm guessing they're not going to be quite as... I'm guessing they're not going to be quite as kind this time with the intro. With the intro. Because we've already... What the fuck? is it? Oh. Oh, fuck. No, no. Oh, the scuffing. Did it just close the door? No. What did it do? Where is it? Okay. Salutation Inspector Merritt? I don't know. Of the Sûreté Nationale. This sounds very French. As you very well know, the chief of police in Calais has turned down my... Is that how you pronounce that? Calais? I don't know. Has turned down my request to pursue Justine Florbel for stealing my son away. Ever since their affair started, Alois, my son, has forsaken his duties to his family and failed to pursue his career. Since the law seems unable to find a crime within the realm of Mademoiselle Justine's actions, I will ask you to receive Dr. Victor Fournier later this week. He is a respectable alieniste, I don't know, and... an expert in the human psyche, and he believes he may have found a legal way to incarcerate her. If he is able to diagnose her as an hysteric, I think that should be ahysteric, I think, it would provide you an ample excuse to have her locked up. I trust you and your agency will not turn us down. Something Lucien... Racine? Yeah. So, it seems that our character here was having an affair with somebody. And their mother is super angry about it. And she's trying to make us out to be the bad guy. A violin or viola. What's this? Just wine, huh? Or an empty bottle. Why is my brain getting all crazy in here? Can I move this? But why would I? There's nothing in here. Okay. Good lord, why is everybody so noisy today? On the outside here. My god. That was not me. That was a motorcycle outside, I swear to god. Things all... Wires! Oh, God. Oh, all the blood from them trying to get the stones out. With their own hands. So what the fuck is going on? Will not budge. Okay.
Whoever you are, if you could help me, I would be much obliged.
What the hell was that?
Help me! Please, help me!
What is this? Wait. Before we do anything. No. That's gonna kill him, isn't it? No, don't pull the lever. Don't pull the lever. Yeah, don't pull the lever. That's gonna kill him. I can, but I need to find a way to save your ass. Justine, my love, I know I am not as talented as Mallow or as strong as Basile. But I am certain my love is truer. Do not my scars tell you so. I will continue to cut myself as long as it pleases you. I would even kill... actually, I think it's supposed to be Basil. If you wish. I know you say you like it, but he is hurting you. I will trick him to consume the bromide. Poor Justine, I will help. Just ask me to help. Alois. I don't know. hell is this? A tennis racket? I am so sorry. Forgive me. What the fuck? My god, why is everything so noisy today? I'm gonna see if I can filter some of this shit out. I am sorry, folks. It is one of the many problems with living in a city.
Our father's name. Our dear name.
Okay, we are certainly female, at least it sounds like we are. What? Oh god, do I really not have a choice here? I guess not. Yeah. That's gonna kill you, isn't it?
Please be reasonable. You don't have to do this.
Fuck. I don't want to. How the fuck can I get this lock off? Are there mementos or notes? Wait, what's this? Oh, okay. What? They can all be saved. She said they can all be saved, but how?
How did you escape?
I guess it was let out? That beats me, dude. What is all this? Oh god, somebody's writing here, so what? They're like rocks that I can pull out of the wall? I don't want to kill this guy.
Have you seen Justine?
I am her, I guess. Why won't we answer him? That's so weird. So, what if I just throw something at the frickin' lock?
Help me! Please, help me!
I mean, fuck. What the hell do I get out of killing this guy? Nothing. I get nothing out of killing this guy. It will not, but fucking. What have I missed? What have I missed? Oh, there's stuff up there. Stack the boxes? Stack the boxes and jump up there, I guess? Wait a minute. What? Am I wasting my time? Oh, fuck. What? I don't know. Okay, put more boxes. Maybe I can get up there. I can't grab the table. I can grab the, the chairs are probably not any good for anything. Shit. God damn it. Fucking figures. I really hope this isn't a waste of time. I really, really want to get up there. Don't fall. Okay. Shit. One more box. Come on.
Can you hear me?
Yes. Give me a moment, please. I am busy stacking boxes to save your ass. Okay, please don't fall. You're gonna fall, aren't you? Really? Oh, come on! Fucking fuck. You've gotta be shitting me. Is there any other... What if I... Can I... No? What the fuck?
How did you escape?
Fine.
Have you seen Justine?
God, I really don't want to do this. Does it? What does this do? For what purpose? I have to know. I have to know. I really fucking have to know. No, no, no. Oh, my tower of lies. Oh, no. Okay. Scooch. All right. We gotta do this. I have to know. I'm sorry. I have to know. That's all there is to it. I have to know if there's something up here that's worth going up there for, if I could have prevented myself from having to kill this guy. Because she did say they can all be saved. Nope, fuck. Okay. One more box. One more. And that should do it, right? I hope. No! Oh, you fuck. Can I just not get up here? Fuck. You know what? Fuck it. I don't see anything. No. Screw it. Just go up the ladder. Just go up the fucking ladder. I didn't want to have to kill the poor guy. But I couldn't see any other way to get out. Not that killing him would be the way out, but... Well, what the fuck is this? Oh. Alright, then. I still have no lantern fuel. Oh god, it's all webby. Please don't have any giant spiders. Please no giant spiders. Biggest idiot of them all. I am the biggest idiot of them all. I am the biggest fucking idiot of all time. God. Fuck out of here. What? Really? No? No, that's not... What? What? But... No... Really? Really? No... Okay. Never mind. I guess I really have no fucking idea what I'm talking about. Welcome to the Notorious BLT channel, where I spend 20 minutes fucking around and not doing much of anything. And listening to fucking sirens and shit go by constantly. What is this garbage today? Oh, I hate this. How are all you roaches still alive with all these webs in here? I would have thought a spider would have gotten you by now. Is Is this blocked? This is blocked. Fuck. Okay. What? What was that? Oh. What if we aren't Justine? What if we're just some poor girl? I see the thingy. Oh, fuck. I should probably listen to it, huh? There's no cylinder in the phone. Fuck. Okay. I'm assuming this cannot be opened. Will not budge. Okay. What is this? Oh, is this where I... This is where I walked by earlier, isn't it? Or is it? I don't fucking know. Fuck the sounds in this game. Please don't be a gooby. Close the door.
Congratulations for coming this far. I'm so excited for you. I do hope you managed to save Monsieur Fournier. He was a friend and a colleague of my papa, you know. Friendly fellow. A real bon garçon, but frail of mind. He puts up an impressive front, but it is all an act, I assure you. Please, go on. We are just getting started.
I wasn't actually able to save him, and I'm not sure why. Travesty at the conservatory. Many Parisians had gathered last night to enjoy the performance of violin virtuoso Malo de Vigny. It was to be the grand premiere of several new arrangements of songs by fellow composer George Bizet. But the evening took an unexpected turn. Young Malo de Vigny turned up visibly intoxicated. His violin cried as the bow was jerked across the strings. The audience seemed forgiving at first, but started to boo the man off stage as he defaced the beloved song La Rose et le... La Rose et something. The stress apparently got the best of the young musician as he threw his bow into the audience and finally collapsed. Mademoiselle Justine Forbel, who is, according to rumors, romantically involved with Monsieur de Vigny, looked quite amused by the event and had two of her friends, Basil Giroy and Elois Racien, carry him off stage. Off the stage. The evening was saved by the music's or by the musicians at the conservatory who doesn't make sense. Wait, by other musicians at the... Oh, okay. By other musicians at the conservatory who was... That still should be who were able to perform a most delightful impromptu concerto in Malo de Vigny's absence. The audience showered their saviors with praise and calls for encore when awarded with spectacular pieces of both Offenbach and Chopin. Okay. Interesting. All right. I don't see any cylinder in here that I can plug into the thingy. Can I, like, do something with you, or... Yeah, whatever. All right. Nothing. Good lord, why is it now that everybody and their mother wants to be so fucking noisy outside? Just shut up and let me play my games, you scumbags. All right. There's no cylinder in another one, so... Gloomy space downstairs became a playground, a mysterious place for Justine to discover with her friends. This, it doesn't look good. This doesn't look good.
On this next piece, you should be looking for some divine inspiration. Time to delve into your spiritual side. What do you see? Is the man begging for mercy, or is he being blessed?
Oh, perhaps both. Fuck.
Father used to say there were no right answers. Have the light guide you.
Hmm. Am I finally gonna get some fucking oil? Picked up slide number 2. Just give me lantern oil for okay, light this. At least get some light. Hmm. I think I'm starting to understand maybe what's, like, what I'm supposed to do. I don't know. Slide number 1. The tests have been going well. The most long-term, and in a sense, the most promising one is the light box. Having Justine choose a slide, essentially a mood for every day, is a great way to see the larger overall development of her mind. She definitely reads things into the slides I had not foreseen. Her remarkable imagination turns the characters into just about anything, and she is able to effortlessly reduce all her experiences into one of the 4 character slides. Using the puzzle lock has proven more difficult, as she tends to always choose 2 sides with characters facing the same way. Wait a minute. Using the puzzle lock has proven more difficult, as she tends to always choose 2 sides with characters facing the same... Hmm. I've asked her why this is, but she doesn't seem to fully understand what I'm asking. These are definitely hints of some kind as to what it is that I can do to solve the puzzles. Ooh, broom spear! Come here. I'll use you. I jab you at enemies. They don't like it. Because I go... What is it? But come here. Are you stuck? Are you stuck in the books? Oh god, I lodged my broom spear. Yeah, whatever. Alright. Enough dicking around. Okay. Like, this kind of seems like they're alluding to things that we're going to do because we don't fully understand what's going on. Picked up slide 4.
Who are you? Who's there?
No.
You'll burn for this. You'll burn for this.
Frame stencil with silhouette of a man. So where's slide 3? And what's this? Justine, age 8. Today I played outside with Clarice. We saw a bird pick at a snail. It carried it off and landed on the lawn fence. The snail had a shell and it cracked. Clarice cried and I comforted her. The new maid heard us and came out and scolded Clarice for playing with with me. The bird took off into the air. Today I was the one with open arms. Justine, age 9. Today I played with the slides from Father's lightbox. Above all, I like the man standing to the right. Father asked why. I said he sees things he likes. Today I was the right one. Father said, Justine, age 10. Father said I picked the wrong slide yesterday when I made the chambermaid cry. He wanted me to pick the one with the sword while I picked the man on the right. I never picked the one with the sword. Today I was the one kneeling. Justine, age 11. Today Father came for me in my room. I still couldn't look him in the eyes. He said I shouldn't feel ashamed and that I only tried to fill the void left by my mother. When he wasn't looking, I took the star stone from his collection. Today I was the one with the sword. What? I'm guessing this is the father, this is the mother. Oh no, that's Justine. That's probably the mother. And... oh hell. There's a naked man. Getting tortured. Hmm. Seems like it could be Spoopy Town. What do we have here? Is there anything here? There must be, right? But where? Okay, not any of these, I guess. Maybe one or two of these? I don't know. What? Wait, what's this? Slide 3. Okay. So, what do these all say here? Silhouette of a man. Silhouette of a man. Silhouette of a man. What the hell's this? Oh, strange how we don't actually cast a shadow or anything. The fuck is that? What the fuck? Why can't I move? Okay, what's up with this dude?
Sick. Twisted. Child.
Wait, no. No, no, no. Take it back. Take it back. Take it back. What if I... Okay, so this'll tell me... I am very confused. Okay, man with his arms open. Man with a sword. Man kneeling. Probably, it looks like in prostration or sad. Triumphant. Nope. Soul journal entries. Saw a bird. Clarice crying, comforted her. Yeah, it was the man with open arms. He wanted me to pick the one with the sword. Father said I picked the wrong slide yesterday while I made the chambermaid cry. Or when I made the chambermaid cry. He wanted me to pick the one with the sword while I picked the man on the right. I never picked the one with the sword. Still couldn't look him in the eyes. He said I shouldn't feel ashamed and that I only tried to fill the void left by mother. When he wasn't looking, I took the star stone from his collection. Today I was the one with the sword. What does any of this mean? What does any of this mean? What the fuck?
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. The kingdoms of this world are become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ, our Savior. King of kings, Lord of lords.
God damn it. Having Justine choose a slide, essentially a mood for every day, is a great way to see the larger overall development of her mind. She definitely reads things into the slides I had not seen before. Or, I had not foreseen, rather. Using the puzzle box. Lock has proven more difficult, as she tends to always choose two slides with characters facing the same way. I have asked her why this is, but she doesn't seem to... So, let's figure out which ones have people facing the other way. All right. First slide. Facing left? With his arms open? Okay, his first slide is left. That's also left. Oops. So one, two are left. Maybe three and four are right. So why don't we... Which one was three? Let's do three, and then either one or two. Okay, so... wait a minute. This? Yes. Shit. Okay, so I want the one that's kneeling. Fuck. Did I say one and three? God damn it. Okay, three definitely. Which one's two? Is it the sword? Right? Wanted me to pick the one with the sword. So let's do... Was it two? God damn it. I'm sorry. Yeah, two. Let's do two and three. Two kind of arbitrarily, but three because... Okay. Fuck. That's not what I wanted. I was hoping to save him. Oops. Okay, I can't move that, I guess. I was really hoping I would save him, but I didn't. So now what? Now what do I do? Oh. I wonder if this gives you a different path for each, like, different answer you give. Alright, folks, I think that's gonna have to do it for this episode. I hope you all did enjoy it. And if you know what to do, that is gonna be it for me, Notorious BLT. I hope you have a fantastic day, and I will catch you all next time. Bye-bye, everybody.